Hello everyone. In the previous video, we have seen definition and generation of free radicals and reactive oxygen species. In today's video, we will discuss free radical quenching enzymes along with the discussion of various multiple choice questions. To download lecture notes and other interesting stuff related to biochemistry, please visit my website, that is www.biochemistrybasics.com. Free radical quencher systems. There are five important substances which are acting as a free radical quencher. And they are, first one, superoxide dismutase, glutathione peroxidase, glutathione reductase, catalase, and the last one is polyphenols. Among all this, first four are the example of enzymes. This is the picture showing the reaction involving free radical quenching enzymes. First one is the superoxide dismutase. There are two types of superoxide dismutase. First one is the cytosolic and the second one is the mitochondrial. Cytosolic is the copper zinc dependent while mitochondrial is the manganese dependent. This superoxide dismutase converts superoxide anion into the hydrogen peroxide and oxygen. Any gene defect in superoxide dismutase leads to amyotrophic lateral sclerosis. And the hydrogen peroxide which is produced at the end of this reaction is converted to water by glutathione peroxidase. Glutathione peroxidase is the selenium dependent enzyme. And this glutathione peroxidase also converts reduced glutathione into the oxidized glutathione. Glutathione is an example of tripeptide which is synthesized by the combination of three amino acids, that is glutamic acid, cysteine and glycine. And this oxidized glutathione is again converted to the reduced form by glutathione reductase enzyme. This glutathione reductase enzyme requires NADPH as a coenzyme. And this NADPH is coming from the HMP shunt pathway. In HMP shunt pathway, this NADPH is synthesized by glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase. That's why in G6PD deficiency, there is no enough availability of NADPH, so there is no synthesis of reduced glutathione. That's why RBCs are more prone for hemolysis in G6PD deficiency. So these are the reactions involving the free radical quenching enzymes. First one is the superoxide dismutase, second one is the glutathione peroxidase, and the third one is glutathione reductase. If H2O2 is generated in large quantities, then catalase is also used for its removal. Catalase converts this H2O2 into oxygen and water molecule. So catalase is the fourth enzyme involved in free radical quenching enzyme system. Now, polyphenols. Consumption of polyphenol-rich fruits, vegetables and beverages is beneficial to human health. They contain flavones, isoflavones, flavanols, catechins and phenolic acid. They act as an antioxidant, anti-apoptosis, anti-carcinogenic and anti-inflammatory. So that's all about polyphenols. Now we will see various multiple choice questions. First question is, all are free radical quenching enzymes except, and the options are superoxide dismutase, glutathione peroxidase, glutathione reductase and carbonic anhydrase. So we have seen there are four free radical quenching enzymes. First one is superoxide dismutase, second one is glutathione peroxidase, third one is glutathione reductase and fourth one is catalase. So the correct answer is D, carbonic anhydrase. Second question is, glutathione is synthesized from all except, and the options are glutamic acid, glycine, methionine and cysteine. As we have discussed, glutathione is a tripeptide which is synthesized by a combination of three amino acids, that is glutamic acid, cysteine and glycine, and it is also known as a gamma glutamyl cystinyl glycine. So the correct answer is C, methionine. Last question is, selenium dependent enzyme is, and the option are superoxide dismutase, glutathione peroxidase, glutathione reductase and catalase. So we have already seen superoxide dismutase. There are two types. One is the mitochondrial, which is manganese dependent, M for M. And second one is the cytosolic, which is copper zinc dependent. And the glutathione peroxidase is the selenium dependent. So the correct answer is B. These are my references. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe Biochemistry Basics by Dr. Amit. And don't forget to press the bell icon so you can get all the notifications from it. Thank you.